Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudoku and Puzzles. Ashish here, and today I'll be covering a puzzle genre called Yajilin Battleship Puzzle. So this puzzle comes into the loop puzzle category and it's a variation of a Yajilin puzzle. There are two genres mixed into one single puzzle, a different Yajilin puzzle and a battleship puzzle, and both of these puzzles are merged into a single hybrid puzzle. So this puzzle was featured on Grandmaster's Puzzle, gmpuzzles.com, and the constructor of this puzzle is Freddy Han. Freddy is an excellent solver. At a very young age, he started solving puzzles at a very good speed, and he has beaten some top solvers too in many of the online tournaments. And coming on to the construction, he has constructed very good puzzles in the past too. So this is one of his very good construction here. And before going to the puzzle, I would say something about this Yajilin Battleship puzzle. There is an ebook on the GM Puzzle store, Yajilin Battleship ebook store, ebook puzzle that has been constructed by Serkan Yurekli. Serkan is an excellent author, I would say, and I have solved all of his puzzles, Yajilin Battleship puzzle, from the ebook. And I would highly recommend you to check out the ebook, because you would really, really love to solve all those puzzles. All the puzzles are really beautifully designed and are purely logical, and the fun that I have gained by solving those puzzles is really priceless. It's really fun puzzles, and I would again highly recommend you to check out the ebook store on GM Puzzles website. I'll add the link in the description below for the ebook store, as well as the link of the website from where this puzzle has been taken, and even the link of the online interface of the puzzle that we are solving today, right? So it's really highly recommended that you check out the ebook store, purchase the ebook if you can. It has some amazing 50 plus puzzles in the ebook, and you'll really, really enjoy those puzzles, right? And before going to the puzzle, I would again request you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. Click on the bell icon so that you can get the notification of the videos that we are covering on a daily basis, and we'll be motivated to do more of the videos in the coming future. And if at all you have any request for any puzzle genre or a Sudoku variant, do let us know on the comments below so that we can cover a video on that too, right? Now coming on to the puzzle. So in a Yajilin puzzle, as we know, that we need to shade some cells, some white cells, in such a way that all the other white cells except the shaded cells form a single closed loop. That is what the Yajilin rule says. And the arrow, the number with the arrow indicates the number of shaded cells in the particular direction, right? That is what the Yajilin rule says. And the battleship rule is nothing but, in battleship we have outside clues given in such a way that the particular row and column will have ship segments by shaded. I mean to say, they will have ship segments. So the standard fleet of ships has been given below the rules, so you can check it out. And those fleets will have to be placed in the battleship grid, right? And the outside clues indicate the number of ship segments in the particular row or column. But you don't have outside clues here. Instead, you have a Yajilin clues here, right? So instead of in a Yajilin, we shade a single cell, and those shaded cells doesn't touch each other even orthogonally. I would say they doesn't touch orthogonally. But in this case, the shaded cells acts as a fleet, the ship segments, right? So you have a ship segment like 4, then 2-3 ship segments, then 3 2s, and single 4 single ship segments, right? So in this case, the number indicates the number of ship segments in that particular direction, and you have to place all the ship segments in this grid. And apart from that, all the white cells will form a single closed loop like in the Yajilin grid, right? So with that, we'll start solving this puzzle. It seems to be very good puzzle, because you know, if you see the theme, there are only twos, all the twos given here, and three of the regions doesn't have any clue, and three of the regions have all the two clues. Excellent theme, right? So this is what is the beauty of the handcrafted puzzles, right? He is an excellent solver. Freddy Hand is an excellent solver and excellent constructor as well. So you can even check out the Serkan's ebook. He is really an excellent constructor, I would say. I have solved all of his puzzles from the ebook, and I would again highly recommend you to check out the ebook and purchase the book if you can, right? So coming on to the puzzle, we'll not just exactly draw the fleet ships or shape of that ship. Instead, we'll just mark it with the shaded cell indicating the fleet here, the ship here. So if you can see, the loop cannot be formed inside the single cell where you have the gray cells. So gray cells cannot have the loop passed through it, right? So gray cells are an exception. Only white cells should have the loop passed through it. So these both are the ship segment. So we are not sure if the ship segment will extend or not. So this is a ship segment because you cannot have something going inside this loop segment and then again coming out. So this is, so ship segments here, in a Yajilin rule, we know that the shaded cells can touch each other diagonally. But in a battleship, you know that the ship segments cannot touch each other diagonally. So in this case, in this genre, the hybrid genre, the ship segments can touch each other, cannot touch each other diagonally. So which means that this can be unshaded here. So this is a green cell that indicates that you cannot have a ship segment here, which means that loop has to pass through it, right? And as you can see here, you cannot have a ship segment, whole of ship segment here, an L-shaped ship segment, because that is not possible. The standard fleet of ships are already given and that doesn't have an L shape here, which means a loop has to pass through it, right? And okay, and as you can see, the two here, which means both of these will be ship segments here, and with that we can mark many of the white cells here. So which means that the loop has to pass inside through it, and again like this, right? So this can go up as well, we are not sure of it. So I'm just marking all the loop cells here in the green color so that we get to know what are the remaining cells that will have the ship segments. Okay, and so both of these cannot be ship segments, right? For the two here, as you can see, both of these cannot be ship segments, because if both of these are ship segments, this has to be white, because this cannot again be a ship cell. And that means that you won't have a loop coming inside it, which means that this has to be a ship segment now. And with that, we continue the loop here downwards and just towards the left. And now we are not sure if this is a ship segment or this is a ship segment. So if this is a ship segment, you will have this as a four cell ship. And if this is a ship segment, then you'll have a two cell and a two cell ship. So anything is possible now. So let us not look over here. There might be some other possibilities here. So if you see the twos here, these two twos are very much helpful here. I would say that there are exactly three possibilities. No, I would say there are exactly, yeah, one. This is one of the possibility. You can just come down here. This is one of the possibilities, right? For the two twos here, including this two. And this is one of the possibilities, right? There are three possibilities here. And two of the possibilities should be a contradiction here. Let's see what happens here is. So what happens is, if let us assume that all these except these three possibilities, are there any other possibilities? Let us see. So if at all I shade this cell, this cell won't be shaded. And of course, both of these cells won't be shaded, because both of these cells are shaded. Then you have only three cells unshaded here and only one ship segment here, which means that this also will have to be shaded. And now for these two, either this way or this way is possible. You cannot have this way or the other way, because one of the twos will have three. So whatever you do here, either this is one of the possibilities here, this is one of the possibilities, right? Or this is one of the possibilities, or this is one of the possibilities, right? There are three possibilities here. Any other possibility is not possible, and again you will come with only all of these three possibilities. And let us see what we have in these three possibilities, right? So if we have these two, these twos will have this way, right? Because there is no other possibility for these two clues. And then you cannot have a ship segment going inside here. A loop going inside here, which is not possible, right? So these, one of the possibilities eliminated here now, right? And let us see if we have any other possibility. Let us see if we have this possibility, right? Now with this possibility, this two and both of these twos are fulfilled, right? Now for this two, you have only these two cells remaining, right? And again, you cannot have a loop segment that can go inside of this. So if a loop segment goes inside, it cannot again come out, right? Which means that this possibility is also eliminated now. And the only possibility remaining is this one now, right? And this ship segment can again extend here. So this ship segment couldn't have extended because you will form an L shape, or either you won't have a loop segment that is going inside. Now this 2 is fulfilled. You can again mark this the diagonal cells that cannot have the loops ship segment here. And now for this two, both of these will be the ship segments, right? And which means that now you can form the loop here. And this loop will have to go up because you will have a closed loop here. This has to come down this way and come down. And now this ship segment cannot go up. So the moment this this loop segment, if it goes up, you form a closed loop inside here. And which means this has to come down. And now this loop segment has to pass through this cell because there is a green cell here, which means that we can mark all the other green cells as well, right? And now let us see, we can mark this as a unshaded cell. Oh, now there is an excellent logic here. What an excellent puzzle this is. Beautifully designed puzzle and excellent solve part too. As you can see, how much it is fun to solve this kind of puzzles, right? And if you can see now, there are, according to the standard fleet that is already being given, we have exactly three ships that have two cell ship segments, right? We have exactly three of those. 1, 2, and 3 are already used, which means that all of the other ship segments cannot be of two cell long, which means that this will have to be a ship segment and this cannot be a ship segment. So if this is a ship segment, again it will have a two cell fleet, which is not possible. So this has to come down this way, and this can be unshaded now, which means this has to be shaded, and we have already formed a four cell ship segment now. And with that, we'll unshade this. This loop has to come, this loop has to come this way and go down now. So we can unshade this as well. And that's an excellent, that was an excellent logic, really a very good logic. So all the two cell ships are already used. 1 4 cell ship is already used, which was in the standard fleet given. And let us see. Oh, that's a great logic here again. So if you see here, there are four. So if you see the below half of the grid, right? If you see the below half of the grid, there are already four loop segments, and all of the four cannot connect to each other because then you will form a single closed loop again. So if this loop segment connects to, we know that this loop segment cannot connect to this, this loop segment cannot connect to this, because then this will get stranded, which means that both of these will be connections, and both of these cannot connect because then you will form a single closed loop here, which means that both of these will have to go towards the upper part of the grid, right? Somehow it will have to go to the upper part of the grid, and which means that these can be unshaded, and of course these also can be unshaded because then you will form a two cell ship again, which means that this loop now goes towards this. And now if you see, this cell is a stranded cell here and a loop cannot pass through it, which means this has to be a ship segment, and again it will be extended because two cell ships are already fulfilled, which means now it cannot be a four cell ship because that is also fulfilled, and it has to be a three cell ship. And now with that, we connect the loops here. Now this can again come down or go straight because you are not sure if this can be a single shell SIP segment. And now there are exactly two SIPs pending. One is a 3-cell and one is a single cell, right? So let us see if we can fulfill those. As you can see, there are exactly three places for the 3-cell SIPs. The first place is this, which is not possible because this cell will get stranded here. This cell, this loop will connect to this loop and this cell will get stranded here. The second is this 3, which is again not possible because this loop segment will get stranded here, which means the third one is this one, and this has to be a 3-cell loop SIP segment. And with that, the only single cell SIP segment is pending here. And let us see, this cannot be the one because if you mark this, this cell will get stranded here and a loop cannot pass through it, right? So this has to be a unshaded cell. Can it be this? So if it is a this, then again this cell will get stranded here and you have 5 single cell SIP segments. You have only one to be fulfilled now, only one is remaining. So again this is not possible, so this has to be unshaded, and which means that this has to go this way. And both of these, if connects, these two cells will get stranded here and it becomes a 2-cell SIP segment. Not possible. So which means this has to come down, this has to go up and come down, and there is only one cell that is remaining here and that has to be a SIP segment. Excellent puzzle, guys, excellent puzzle. What a amazing puzzle this was. As you can see, the theme, as we have already discussed, the theme here is all the twos given here. The three dominoes doesn't have any clues and the three dominoes have two clues in it. Excellent puzzle. What a great solving path this was. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do like and comment again if you want us to solve any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre. And I hope that you subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. That will again motivate us to cover the videos on a daily basis. Right? Thank you.